Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I have a very exciting video. I have been trying to figure out how to do this for a long time. You guys might have seen last year, I posted a reading vlog called Choose Your Own Adventure Reading Vlog, and it was me participating in the Thousand Doors Readathon, and that was like such a fun vlog, like one of the most fun vlogs to film. I really liked the impromptu nature of the challenge. Essentially what it was, or what the readathon is that you start with a prompt, you choose a book to read based off of that prompt, and then depending on what you thought of the book afterwards, it will lead you to another prompt. So you don't know what you're gonna be reading ahead of time, and it's really like a choose your own adventure style reading experience. And I've really been wanting to try to do that on my own, not just as part of the readathon, but like in my own reading. I finally think I figured out how to do it, and I'm really excited. So basically I have all of these prompts. There are 100. I asked you guys on my Instagram to submit prompts, and you guys sent so many good ones. I think that a lot of these I want to, once I'm done with this challenge, I want to incorporate into my TBR jar because they're so good. And basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to have 5 jars, and each jar is going to represent a star rating. And so based on whatever I end up rating the book that I read, that is how I'm gonna choose my next prompt. So each jar is going to have 20 prompts in them, and if I rate a book 3 stars, then I will pick my next prompt from the 3-star jar, and that will be how I select the next one. So there's absolutely no planning ahead, which gives me a little bit of anxiety because you guys know I'm like a hyper planner. I like to plan things out, but I'm really excited because I'm hoping that the sort of like spontaneity of this challenge will help me to read books that aren't like exactly at the top of my TBR, and more ones that are kind of like have been buried. So yeah, some of the challenges in here are just like super fun. We have matches your current outfit, reminds you of a favorite movie, characters travel to a destination, has disability rep. I mean, you guys sent like so many good challenges, and I'm just going to mix them all up and divide them up in between the 5 jars. So I don't really know how this is gonna go. This could end up being like a total fail, but I think over the next like couple of weeks, I am going to try to read all these books. I feel like the hardest part is going to be secretly reading these because I do still have like all of my TBR books that I need to be reading, and I don't necessarily want to pick those for this. So I don't know. We're gonna see how this goes, but I'm really excited. I do need a first book to read. So for my first book, I am just going to choose it myself from a prompt, but then depending on what I rate that book, it will lead me to my next book, and we can start the choose your own adventure reading experiment.
Okay, so here are all of my jars. So this is gonna be 1 star or DNF, 2 stars, 3 stars, 4 stars, and 5 stars. To pick my first book, I think I'll just go right in the middle and pick one of these, and we will see what it is. So the one that I picked is About a Curse,
which means I have to find a book that is about a curse.
Is this about a curse? I feel like this might be. I'm not sure if this is about a curse. Doesn't say. I could reread The Winner's Curse. I could reread this. This is about a curse. Any romances? What romances would be about a curse? Maybe like my fantasy and paranormal romances are about, wait. This one, this is about a curse. Okay, yes, this is about a werewolf curse. So, perfect, let's pick this one.
So the book that I've chosen is Wolf Gone Wild by Juliet Cross. I feel like this would be a fun one to start off with. So this is an adult paranormal romance about a coven of witches. And then there's a werewolf who has a curse placed on him that is preventing him from shifting during the full moon every month. And so his wolf inside him is like going crazy. So he asks this one witch who specializes in hexes to help help break his curse. And I've heard that this is super fun and really funny. So I'm gonna read this today, and then at the end of it, depending on what star rating I give it, we are going to select the next prompt. Okay, so this book is so funny. Oh my god, everyone who recommended this to me and told me that the humor in this was so good is so right. It's basically like everything that I've wanted for so long. I've really been wanting a very witchy romance book that was actually like witch heavy, because I feel like a lot of the romances that I've found with witches in them, the witch elements are just like very much in the background, or witches are kind of like sub characters, but they're not really like the main characters. I have just been wanting a charmed romance book, and I feel like this is giving me those vibes so much. And it kind of is reminding me, like, it has elements of Charmed because we're following this coven of witches who are all sisters, so it has that aspect, and each sister specializes in a different kind of magic. And then it also is giving me vibes of The Originals, because it takes place in New Orleans and there are also vampires and werewolves, and so vampires, werewolves, and witches all sort of like coexist. And then on top of that, it is giving me Venom, which might seem like totally random, but basically the guy, the werewolf character, since he hasn't been allowed to shift, his werewolf is like a separate personality inside of him, and it's going crazy, and it actually like speaks to him. And so you get dialogue of the wolf, which is named Alpha, and he is so funny. And it reminds me of the relationship in Venom that Eddie and Venom have, where like Venom is in his head like, I want to feast on his soul, and just like saying like totally like insane things. And also Alpha is super super horny. So like every time that Mateo, the guy, sees the main character, Alpha is in his head like, we need to have sex with her right now. And so it's just like, I love this. I love this so much. And especially I'm listening to the audiobook, and the narration for Alpha is just like perfect. And Alpha is also super jealous. So there's this scene where Evie brings Mateo to a comic book store because she loves comic books, and she's telling him about how her favorite superhero is Wolverine and how much she loves Wolverine. And in Mateo's head, Alpha is like, I want to fight Wolverine. So I definitely feel like I will be able to finish this today, because I'm just having so much fun with it. It's very rare that I genuinely find a book funny and that I'm laughing at it. I don't know what it is, but I feel like a lot of times like jokes and humor doesn't translate the best in books, but this is like genuinely so funny. Okay, I finished Wolf Gone Wild and I loved this book. This was such a good paranormal romance. I loved the witches. I loved the werewolf aspect of it. The romance was so great. Like, it was so funny. It was amazing. I really can't wait to continue on with this series and follow. The other books are about the other sisters, and one of them I think is gonna have a romance with a vampire character who we saw in this book, and I'm super excited for that. So, first book down, really enjoyed this. So let's go over to the jars.
So, like I said, we're going from 1 star to 5 stars, and I am rating this book 5 stars. So the next challenge that I will pull will be from the 5-star jar. So let me pick one. Let's go with this one. Author who isn't from the US. Okay. So I feel like I have a lot more options for this one. I think that the author of A Winter's Promise isn't from the US, because I think the original translation of this is in French, so I could read that potentially. Empire of Sand, I believe the author is not from the US. Yeah, she's from England, so that is a possibility.
Okay, I found what I am going to read for an author who is not from the US, and it's actually a book that I just got like yesterday, and that is The Library of the Dead. So this author, let's see, it says he grew up in Zimbabwe and has lived in Edinburgh most of his life. So what I know about this is that it says The Sixth Sense meets Stranger Things in a fantasy following a precarious and cynical teen as she explores the shadowy, magical underside of modern Edinburgh. Sounds awesome. Also, literally like any book that starts with the library of, I end up loving. The Library of the Unwritten, the Library of Mount Char, and now we have the Library of the Dead. So let's hope it comes through like these two books did. Okay, I've only read the first page, but I wanted to read you guys the very first sentence because I am already relating to this main character. So the first line says, "I'm not really supposed to be doing this, but a girl's gotta get paid. So here we go." Relatable. Guys, I really don't wanna do this, but I think I need to DNF this book. Oh my god, I have been trying to read this for weeks now, and every time I pick it up, I can't read more than 5 pages at a time before I want to put it down. I'm struggling so much with it, and I think it's just the writing, like something about the writing style is just really not working for me. Like the plot is interesting, the setting is cool, the main character is cool. It's just like the writing is super hard for me to get into. There's a lot of things that I can push through in a book. Like I can push through a plot that's maybe not the most interesting or a character that I don't really like. But if I don't like the writing, it is so hard for me to push through. Like I don't want to DNF this because I wanted to like this so badly, but like, it's putting me in such a slump. I haven't been able to read anything else. So I feel like I just have to DNF it for my own sake. Even though I really, really don't want to, I just have to do it. We have to do it. I'm sorry.
Okay, the one-star jar also count for DNFs. So we're gonna pick the next one. Hopefully this one is better than the last. Let's pick this one, which is Second Chance Author. Okay, so for this one, I need to pick an author who I have previously disliked or rated low. Well, one option is The Song of Achilles by Madeline Miller, since I gave Circe 2 stars. So let me take that out because that is an option. Oh, you know, where is it? Where is it? Oh, up here. It Happened One Summer by Tessa Bailey. I have read a couple Tessa Bailey books and disliked them, and this is kind of like my last ditch effort for her. So this is another option. I feel like those are the only ones that are like pretty obvious to me. So let's see. Very different options here. I already know that a lot of people are probably gonna want me to pick this, but since I just DNF'd a book and I like it took me forever to try to get through it, I kind of want something easy. So I feel like I'm leaning towards this one. Yeah, okay, you know what? We're gonna pick this. Sorry for anyone who really wanted me to read this. It'll happen eventually, just not today.
All right, so I am over halfway through It Happened One Summer, and I'm obsessed with this book. I'm so glad that I'm finally liking a Tessa Bailey book because I've never understood the hype for her. Her books have just never worked for me, but this one is working. It's about a girl who is kind of like a spoiled, rich socialite. At the start of the book, she gets into a big scandal and is arrested. And so because of that, her stepfather cuts her off and tells her that she needs to go to this small little town in Maine and run this old bar to like prove that she's adult and that she's responsible. And so she goes there, she goes to the town. She's very much a fish out of water, superficial LA girl in this little coastal like fishing town. And there she meets this captain who runs this like crab fishing boat. He is like scruffy and grumpy, and Piper just kind of comes in and like unravels his whole life. I love them. I love them. I love him. I feel like I never really have get crushes on characters, even in romance, but Brendan, I would marry him. I would marry him. I'm not even a marriage kind of person, but I would marry him in a freaking heartbeat. I've also never read about a character who has a spoiling kink. Like, he gets turned on by spoiling her. Where are these men? Where are they? I would like to know. I want to be spoiled. This is so good. This is so good. So I finished It Happened One Summer. Y'all, I am so glad that I gave Tessa Bailey another chance. This is why I try not to quit on authors if I've read a book from them that I don't like, because then something like this happens where this is probably my favorite romance of the whole year. Wild, wild. I loved this. The chemistry was so good between Brendan and Piper, and I really liked how they both changed each other, but like for the better. The spice was great. The spice was great. I feel like I couldn't really appreciate how good Tessa Bailey is at writing sexual scenes in her other books that I've read, because I didn't like them and I wasn't enjoying the romance, so I didn't feel the sexual chemistry. Whereas in this book, this had some of the like hottest scenes that I've read. And like I said, I'm in love with this man. I barely even like men, but I'm in love with this man. So clearly, I'm giving this 5 stars. I'm so glad we've had a redemption here, because my last book, I was struggling with so much. I needed this to raise back my spirits. So now we are gonna go back over to the jars and select the next book. All right, so we have 1 through 5. I rated this book 5 stars, so I'm gonna be selecting from this jar over here. And let's do this one, which is Book a Friend Loves. Okay. All right, I'm gonna go onto Instagram and see what some of my friends have recently posted about, and then maybe I'll find something that way. Oh, here we go. Okay, this is what I'm gonna read. Oh my God, okay, wait, I'm excited about this. So Jen from the Book Refuge just posted this picture, this series called Necessary Evils. Here is the first book. It's called Unhinged by Onley James. And I've actually seen a bunch of my friends reading this lately. Like, I know Crystal read this and really, really loved it. And it's kind of been making its way through romance booktube. So I'm gonna choose that. I have it on my Kindle because I just recently did a Come Book Shopping With Me ebook edition. And I got this and the second book. So I have them on my Kindle. What I know about this basically is that it follows a family of psychopaths. So like this billionaire adopted all these children who had been evaluated or diagnosed as having psychopathic tendencies, and he raised them to be like vigilante killers and to kill bad people. And so this first book follows one of those boys who is confronted one day with the son of one of the guys that he's murdered, and they have a little romance together. I've heard great things about this series and it sounds totally up my alley, so I feel like this is gonna be a fun one to read. I also don't think it's too long. I think it's around like 200 pages, so maybe I can read that today. Okay, I've been reading Unhinged for a little bit now. I think I'm like 30% into it, and I don't really know how I feel about it yet. I feel like it's a little bit too insta-lovey for me, the romance part of it. That's just, I feel like insta-love is a trope that I don't really love unless it's done super well. There are some authors I think who can convince me of insta-love. The plot, however, the plot, the writing, this whole family is super interesting to me. I'm loving the actual like killing vigilante plot way more than the actual romance plot, but I feel like it's really balanced. It isn't just focused on the romance, which I'm liking. I'm into it, I'm intrigued. I do think that this is a series that I would probably like other books, other like romantic pairings better than this one. I'm just not super sold on this specific romance, but everything outside of that, I'm really enjoying. So I'm gonna keep reading it. It's like a really fast-paced book, so I do feel like I could finish it within the next couple of hours. Okay, I'm now over halfway through, and I definitely will say I'm more sold on the romance now than I was towards the beginning. I think I just had a hard time like believing the romance, but as it's going, I'm like getting more and more of the connection, and the plot has really picked up right now. I'm really enjoying this plot, which I don't think I really said what it is. Basically, his love interest is the son of the first guy that he killed, and the son finds out that his dad was a terrible person, a pedophile, a sexual offender. His father wasn't working alone. There were a bunch of other men in this like organization who were all hurting kids. And so they team up to find the other guys and kill them. So that's the plot. It's very heavy. It's super dark, but I'm really enjoying it right now. I finished Unhinged. Like I thought, it really did not take me long to read. I think at the start of the book, I was leaning towards giving this 3 stars, but the second half really picked up for me, and I think I'm gonna give it 4 stars. I definitely think that the plot, like the tracking down these bad men and killing them, that whole plot line was really great and totally kind of saved the book for me because I was struggling in the first half. But I'm really excited to read the next book and like continue on in this series. All of the brothers are super fascinating to me. The scenes that we had with like the whole family, I really enjoyed those. And I believe that the next book, the love interest is an FBI agent, which I really want to read. So let's go back over to the jars and we're gonna select the next book. You want to help me? So let's see, I rated Unhinged 4 stars. So this is the 4-star jar, and I'm just gonna pick one. This one is gonna be my last one, so let's hope that it's good. So, I got Girl in the title. Oh no. I don't actually know if I have any books with Girl in the title. A Girl Like Her, I've read that. A Girl in Red, but I've already read that. I feel like I'm gonna have read all of them. Girl in the Tower, but I've already read it. Oh wait, up there, there's a book called Girl A. I have no idea what that is. And I'm gonna have to get my step stool so that I can reach that. Okay, so that's our only option so far, but I don't know what it is. Let me keep looking just in case there's something else. That way I don't have to go get my stool to get that book down. Here's one. I have not read this, War Girls. Okay, so this is another option. Wilder Girls, I've read. Saw Kill Girls, I've read. Slasher Girls and Monster Boys, I've read it. The Final Girl Support Group, I've read it. Down here, Girl Serpent Thorn, I've read that. Girls of Paper and Fire, I've read that. The Good Luck Girls, I've read that. Girl in 6E, I've read that. Ooh! A Good Girl's Guide to Murder. I haven't read this. Okay, so that's another option. These are my 2 options. This is a sci-fi. It says climate change and nuclear disasters have rendered much of Earth unlivable. Only the lucky ones have escaped to space colonies in the sky. Okay, that sounds really interesting. And then this one's a thriller. This is the story of an investigation turned obsession, full of twists and turns with an ending you'll never expect. I think I'm gonna pick this. I'm really in like a thriller mood right now. And even though this one sounds super interesting, I just feel like I'm more in the mood for this. So today I am starting A Good Girl's Guide to Murder by Holly Jackson. So basically this is about this girl who decides to do her senior like project on a murder that had happened in her town a couple years prior, where this girl was supposedly murdered by her boyfriend and then her boyfriend committed suicide, and everyone in town believes that he was guilty, but she knew him and doesn't think that he was capable of murder. So she uses her senior project to investigate and try to figure out what actually happened. I've heard it compared to Sadie a lot, which is a book that I loved, but I'm gonna try not to like go into it with too much expectations of being like Sadie, because that book was fantastic. But I'm excited. I'm in such a thriller mood since we're like getting into the fall time. I love reading like thrillers and kind of like darker books during this time. And I think I'm going to listen to it on audio because I've heard that the audiobook is a full cast. So I feel like the audiobook is the best way to go for this. Okay. I just want to say, I am 80 pages into this and I think I figured out who the killer is. I'm making my prediction. I'm not going to say who, but when I finish, I will tell you if I'm correct or not, but I really think that I am. I think I've solved the case, but this is really good so far. I will say the audiobook, 10 out of 10. It has a full cast. It's so well produced. There's a lot of like interviews and phone calls in here, and when there's a phone call, it actually in the audiobook sounds like a phone call. Like the phone rings, someone answers, it's kind of muffled. I kind of feel like I'm gonna try to finish this today because I'm invested. I wanna know what is happening. I wanna know if I'm right. I hope that I can finish today because I feel like if I have to go to sleep tonight not knowing, I'm gonna be really disappointed. I want to know today. I don't understand how people can read thrillers over the course of a couple days, because it's like, I have to know. And like, when I start the book, there becomes like a running like clock in my head where I'm like, okay, I have to know what this mystery is, and I can't do anything else until I know. And that clock has started. So if I have to go to sleep tonight and I haven't finished this yet, I'm gonna have a terrible night's sleep. Okay, I was right. I was right. I was right. Y'all, I should be a freaking detective. However, there's still quite a bit left. I feel like maybe something else is gonna happen. Oh! Okay. I was right about some of it. I was right about one thing, but then there was another thing. Like, I was right about the twist, but then there was a twist on top of the twist that I didn't know. That was the best of both worlds, because I love being right and I love being surprised. So I got both. The last like 30 pages of this book was like kind of intense. I don't know how I feel, so I'm gonna think about it for a bit. Actually, I'm gonna now watch the new episode of Only Murders in the Building, which is a show that I'm like obsessed by, and kind of, this book kind of reminded me of it, because the show Only Murders in the Building is about these three people who are like true crime podcast fans, and someone in their building is murdered, so they decide to start their own podcast, like investigating the murder, and it's such a good show. So I'm gonna watch the new episode, kind of let this book sink in a little bit, and then I'll let you guys know my final thoughts. So I've had a little bit of time to think about this book. I feel like there were things about it that I really enjoyed, and then there were some things that didn't work that well for me. And I know I said I'm not gonna compare it to Sadie, but I feel like I need to kind of compare it a little bit in order to explain why certain elements of this didn't work. So in terms of like the actual mystery, I really liked that part, and I really liked the way that it was told with all of the phone calls and interviews and text messages. The audiobook was fantastic. If you are gonna read this, I highly recommend listening to it on audio, because I feel like that really enhanced my experience. However, I think that what didn't work for me was the main character. And I think that Sadie is a perfect example of telling the story from the point of view of the right narrator. I love Sadie so much. It is a book that I read so long ago, and it still has like stuck with me. And I think that the reason is that Sadie is not only the main character, but she's also the mystery. And so because of that, you get really, really attached to her. You learn a lot about her. She's a very important part of the story. Without Sadie, there is no story. Whereas this book, the main character, I don't even remember her name. Pip. She could have been replaced with literally anybody. She had no real like connection to the mystery, other than she kind of knew one of the victims when she was younger. But other than that, she was like a third party outside observer. Because of that, I felt like she was just really a vessel for us as a reader to experience this mystery, but I never got attached to her as a character. So because of that, because there was like, I wasn't attached to the main character, it kind of kept everything almost at a distance, and there wasn't a lot of like emotional investment in this story. Whereas like with Sadie, I got so emotionally invested in what happened. Like, the ending of that book broke me. But I did think that the mystery in here was really good, and I liked getting all of the clues and stuff. But I guess another thing that kind of frustrated me was that I don't think that the main character was putting the clues together in the best way. Like I said, I figured out at least one of the twists very early on, and I had all the same clues that she did. So it was getting more and more frustrating as the book was going on, that she just like wasn't connecting the dots. And she also did a lot of things that were just so dumb. Like, she would go to dangerous places and not tell anybody that she was there or that she was going there. And I'm just like, you're asking for someone to kill you. I think that I'm gonna give this 3.5 stars. It was entertaining. I liked the mystery, but I never felt super connected to this. So yeah, 3.5 stars. It was entertaining. If you're looking for just like a really quick, fast-paced YA thriller, I would recommend it. And I definitely would recommend the audiobook. I think that I wouldn't have liked it nearly as much had the audiobook not been as amazing as it was. So, like I said, that is the last book that I'm going to be reading for this vlog. This was super fun. I feel like this was very successful. I read 2 5-star books, a 4-star book, 3.5-star, and one DNF. I gave an author a second chance and ended up loving one of her books. I would love to do this again at some point. Like you guys saw, I have so many challenges in those jars. So definitely let me know if this is something you want me to do again. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!